Well, John, we are at City Hall because this weekend there will be a rally for transgender workers. Tonight, though, the focus was on educating people about their rights and the fight ahead. They were important topics of conversation in South City.
Bam.
Making buttons to support transgender individuals. And learning more about Tuesday's case at the U.S. Supreme Court brought folks in the LGBTQ community together Monday night.
Tomorrow's a huge deal.
They're fighting to have the same federal rights straight people already have, to not be treated differently in the workplace, to have the same protections. Justices will be deciding if all workers are covered by sex-based discrimination language in the 1964 Civil Rights Act.
As long as they can do the job and they're showing up and they're doing the job, it shouldn't really matter what their sexual orientation is, what their religion is, what their race is. It shouldn't matter.
Beth Gombos tells me about losing numerous jobs. Beth is trans.
Everybody that I told didn't believe me. Like, they were just like, oh, you're young, you just lost the job. And they didn't want to listen to how I was ostracized by my coworkers or treated differently.
If the LGBTQ community loses at the high court, their fight is far from over. That fight might involve civil disobedience.
Just because the Supreme Court says one thing doesn't mean that people follow that direction. Doesn't mean that we're going to settle for that to be all we deserve in the future.
If history is any indication, we probably won't learn of the Supreme Court's ruling until next spring, May or June. The rally here for the transgender workers takes place on Sunday at 11 a.m. In downtown St. Louis, I'm Rocky Madden, Fox 2 News.
Thanks.